being understood how much of CO2 that we are emitting in this atmosphere and what is its current concentration. Let us now start looking at the impact that it is causing in terms of the climate change. I told you that it has already resulted in a global warming of 1 degree centigrade. And what is this 1 degree centigrade is doing on this planet? What is the impact it is having? It is literally causing havoc on this planet. Though 1 degree sounds very small number, and people in the hotter climate can say that the summer temperatures are going up to 45, 46, 40, or sometimes 50 degrees centigrade. In the winter season, the temperature goes to 4, 5 degrees centigrade, sometimes you are negative. What is the big deal about 1 degree centigrade? As I told you, this 1 degree centigrade is resulting in imbalance in the weather pattern. It is resulting in many natural ecosystems to change. For example, the weather pattern itself has changed. The summers are not anymore the same. The winters are not anymore the same. The monsoons are not anymore the same. The time is shifting. The erratic weather patterns are becoming more and more normal. There used to be a time when every season you could predict by the day, by the week, but it is very difficult to predict, and there are unpredictable behavior that we are observing. And I keep asking people that, do you require a scientific data to tell you that the weather pattern has changed? And answer is no. It is our day-to-day experience that we can feel that the weather pattern has changed. Not only that, this 1 degree centigrade global warming is having very noticeable impact and a very serious impact on many aspects of the natural life. For example, there are now forest fires of enormous magnitude. There was a forest fire in Amazon forest, in Australian forest, and even in California in America. Now these forest fires were huge by any imagination, and all the scientific knowledge and all our economic might was not sufficient to control these forest fires. Millions and millions of acres of forest got burned, and even billion animal and insect got burned alive. So that's the impact of 1 degree centigrade of global warming. What else it is doing? It is resulting in a bizarre events like snowfall in desert areas. I come from Madhya Pradesh in a Khargone and Khandwa district, and few weeks back there was a severe hailstorm, and the whole district and wherever there was a hailstorm, that part became like a Kashmir. That is the impact of 1 degree centigrade. The sea, which is such an enormous water body, can you imagine that the sea level itself is changing and rising, and the change in the sea level is very significant. Almost last year, the rate at which the sea is now increasing is in the range of about 3 millimeter plus every single year. That's a huge change, just 1 degree centigrade. Because of the sea level, the water is now going into the cities and the fields which are the low-lying area. Bangladesh is a good example. One of the significant reason for the migration of population from the coastal area is increase in the sea level. What else it is doing? It is resulting in a glacier melting. And whenever people talk about climate change, one of the image that comes in front of our eyes is the glacier melting. How significant is the glacier melting? You can see that whatever the ice cap cover was there, it is receding and receding, and there is on an average about 3.5 million square kilometers of ice cap has melted. And as a result of that, enormous water is now getting into the sea and resulting in a sea level rise. What is happening because of the ice caps are melting, that it is leaving behind a dark surface of the sea. As a result of that, there is more even higher level of absorption, and therefore it will accelerate the global warming even more. There is something called permafrost, which is a kind of a rock formed because of the clay and the water when it is at much below the freezing temperature. Now when the temperatures are increasing, the permafrost is melting, and the danger is that whatever the organic matters which are burned underneath, the organic matter will now degrade, and whenever we degrade a biomass and other organic matter, it results in methane, and methane is another greenhouse gas having 20 times stronger impact on the climate change than the carbon dioxide. All this is because of 1 degree centigrade rise in the temperature. So imagine, just 1 degree centigrade itself is causing such a major change in the global weather system. What will happen to the planet if it becomes warmer and warmer and warmer? So therefore, one of the very significant number of the climate change is 1.5 degree centigrade. In fact, the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change has come up with this report of 1.5 degree centigrade global warming. And as per this report, 1.5 degree centigrade is one of the very significant number for the entire humanity on this planet. Why it is significant? Because once the global warming crosses 1.5 degree centigrade, the change in the global weather system, the change in the climate will start to become irreversible. And there are many local ecosystems within the bigger system. There is an ecosystem of monsoon itself, there is an ecosystem of the crops itself, there is an ecosystem of sea level rise itself, and there is an ecosystem of coral reefs itself. There are many ecosystems that are part of this planet. And every ecosystem will have different tipping point or the threshold global warming beyond which they will not be able to come back or be corrected or reversed. Therefore, at that tipping point, it will result in an irreversible change. And the global warming beyond 1.5 degree centigrade will start to become irreversible. So ideally, we should stop global warming at 1.5 degree centigrade, if not 2 degree centigrade. So between 1.5 to 2 degree centigrade, there's a window when more and more local, the ecosystem will start crossing the tipping point and will start to become irreversible. So therefore, I'm repeating again, 1.5 degree centigrade of global warming has to be one of the most important significant number for the entire humanity. And we should do everything in our capacity, in our effort, to ensure that the global temperatures does not cross 1.5 or maximum 2 degree centigrade. So the next big question is, how much time is left to us before the global temperature rises to 1.5 degree centigrade? 500 years, 200 years, 100 years, 50 years, 40 years, 30 years, 20 years, 10 years? Not even that. There is what is called the carbon budget. What is carbon budget? So there is a direct correlationship between the cumulative amount of carbon dioxide that exists on the planet and the global temperature it will result in, global temperature rise that it will result in. So there's a linear correlationship. So at 1.5 degree centigrade, before we reach 1.5 degree centigrade, we can still afford to emit about 300 billion tons of carbon dioxide. 300 billion tons of carbon dioxide looks like a big number, but I told you already that every year we are emitting about 42 billion tons. So 300 billion tons divided by 42 billion tons, you'll figure out that the time left with us with the current rate of carbon dioxide emission is only about 7 years, or even less than 7 years. There is a climate clock that is ticking, and if you follow this climate clock, you'll figure out that not much time is left. And this climate clock is running faster and faster. Why? Because our carbon dioxide emission rate is becoming higher and higher. So the time left to us to make the correction is even lower and lower. So 1.5 degree centigrade is ideally we should stop. It is not that at 1.5 degree centigrade suddenly enormous change will happen. No, it will not. But what will happen, as I told and I'm repeating again, the change in the pattern well, it starts to become irreversible. So therefore, let us wake up. Let us realize the danger that we are in, the entire humanity. And let us figure out what should we do in order to solve this climate change problem, because it is not a simple problem of one country. It is not a single problem of one region, one state, or one caste. It is a problem for the entire humanity. And this climate change problem is just not a problem. It is becoming existential threat. As Dalai Lama mentioned, that more and more people now realizing that the existence of humanity is at stake, and only doing prayers and pranayam and meditation is not going to be enough. We need to take an action. And that's why, quoting Dalai Lama's word, we need action. An action, the IPCC, the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, which is the intergovernmental body of 180 countries, in its report mentions that the action that we need has to be drastic and immediate in terms of energy use pattern. So if you are going to take an action for making your choices in terms of using energy, because the fossil energy is causing the climate change, if you are going to take an action, if your country is going to take an action, make sure that the action is drastic and immediate. So qualify your action against these two words. If your action is not drastic, if your action is not immediate, then whatever you are going to do is not going to be sufficient, and it will only be feel-good factor. I hope you will realize the severity and seriousness of the catastrophic climate change. Let us all together start taking some action, however small it is, but let us accelerate our action so that the whole world together, we can mitigate climate change and ensure that the human life survives on this planet for centuries and centuries to come. In the next session, we'll start discussing what are the corrective actions that we can do, what should be our approach in making the energy choices, what should be the energy that we should use to run our daily life, our schools, our universities, and our industries. Thank you very much. See you in the next session.